So I'm here with Noella, and she is Kettner's sister, who we just heard from, and she's going to share her story as well.
Hi, my name is Noella, so I'm gonna tell my story. I've been born in Rwanda. When I was like 4 years old, we went to Holland to live there. My mother is a born-again Christian. My father is not a born-again Christian. My oldest sister came as first to faith. And after that, we went always to the church. But I was like a kid, I went because it was fun with other kids, you know. But yeah. And now I am and after that we lived for like 10 years or 9 years in Holland. After that we went to Belgium, and I was like 13 years old, and I was really mad at my parents because I didn't want to leave my friends, everything I knew. And yeah, it was really hard for me to make a switch, you know. And after that we went to a new high school, and I couldn't find my place there. I couldn't find out who I was. After that I always make like a fight with my parents. I didn't listen to them. And after that we moved again to another house, and we went to another school. I liked it there because I could dress however I wanted, and I could like, yeah, I really enjoyed it there. But I couldn't be myself because I started to put a mask on my face. Like I always like acting all happy and joyful, but I was not joyful at all because in the night I always cried myself to sleep. I came in a deep depression because when I was 4 years old or little in Rwanda, I've been molested by someone, and it really like it was a shock for me, and I always was scared like, did it really happen or did it not happen? Like I was always confused, and I always tried to justify myself like I can do that because someone has done this to me. I always felt sorry for myself, and but nobody knew that I was going through those things. After that, I came to a really dark period, and I really was like, yeah, I was really thinking about death. I really wanted, I w really w was thinking about the afterlife, but I also wanted God to speak to me in a like very special way, like that He really directly speaking to me, not someone telling me, and always like searching love in other things, in guys, in just that love feeling. And one day I really like was a Sunday because we always went to church. One day on Sunday I couldn't smile anymore. I couldn't act like I was happy anymore. And I was in the church. I was sitting, but I didn't listen to the preaching. And there was like a guest speaker, and he was like talking. After that, he said something very strange. He said, "There's someone here, and I want to say Jesus is holding you." And I was like there sitting there. I was like, no, it's not about me. No, it's not about me. I was like very proud in my heart. And after that, at the sermon, the preacher came to us, and he came, and I was trying to avoid him because I didn't want to make eye contact. But he came, and he told me, "Are you?" He asked me, "Are you happy?" And I was like, yes, I'm happy. I lied." And he saw it, and he told asked us like, "Can I pray for you?" So he prayed for us all, and I was like trying to hold up my tears because no one really told me those things, you know. And weeks, days went by, and it really echoes in my head like, "Are you really happy? Are you really happy?" And I got a Bible that I got from a friend in Holland who is not a Christian, still not. And I started to read it, and I really started to understand what the gospel meant. I really understand what Jesus did on the cross for me, and He really loved me. And I went in my room to I knew that I needed to repent because I sinned against. I did a lot of things. I was like addicted to a lot of things, and God really like put it like on my heart to confess all my sins and to put it on the cross. So also my hurt, my fear, what happened in my childhood, God really like washed it all over me, and I felt so amazing peace I never felt before. And yeah, and during those days, God really like discipled me. And also I was really addicted to watching TV because I always want to escape reality. And also God put it on my heart to stop with it and just to be alone with Him in a secret place. And that's how I'm growing right now, and I am like so happy right now. Like the real happiness comes from God. So yeah, that's my story.